So today is gonna be a good day. And why is it gonna be a good day, Nick? Because we get to vlog. Oh yeah. You might be wondering, hey Nick, why don't you vlog every day? Well, I'm a part of the newly created social media unit for the police department. And we manage all of our social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. I'll put the handles down below in the description to make sure you guys go follow us on Instagram and Facebook and all that good stuff. A part of managing the social media platforms, we have to create content. So that takes up a lot of the time. We work 4 10-hour shifts per week. So that means I'm here for 4 days. One of those days, I just vlog. That's all I do. I'll try to make a fun day, interesting day, like go to the range, go on patrol. And today we have a busy schedule. Headed into work now, got an early morning meeting, then gonna film something for Facebook. We have our Miami Police Air Unit coming in and we're gonna go on a ride along with them. Choppers!
Byers, what's going on? Good morning.
Sir.
Talk to me. What we got going on?
I don't know, but some of your workers came in there.
Mm-hmm.
For our computer screen. I'm snitching because I don't have one. I want
hey,
some too. That's all I'm saying. I want some too. That's all I'm saying. I mean, be nice. Share. Sharing is caring. That's all I know.
So I come into the office today and this is what I see. What? Caesar's here. What? Letitia. Still sitting on the couch. We need to get her a desk. We got some monitors in. Oh yeah, well guys, I gotta take a second and hook up my monitor and then I'll show you. Hold on 1 second. Set up. Look at that monitor. And we're just waiting for our meeting that I told you guys about. And after the meeting, we're going to meet up with the air unit.
All right guys, meeting's over. I'm gonna pack up my stuff, head up to the helipad to meet the air unit. Time to go. Let's go.
All right, guys, up on the roof of the station, and as you saw in vlog 4, this is where the helicopter comes and goes. I'm literally flying solo. Well, as far as social media is concerned, Sarge and Tisha Fierce went over to the airport to get the helicopter taking off. They're gonna get some shots of the helicopter taking off. And I'm here waiting for the helicopter to arrive at the helipad. See, here's the helipad right here.
Nick, we're coming to get you.
Officer Morgo and Sergeant Baroto.
Yes, sir.
What's going on?
What's
good
up,
to see you.
Everything likewise, man.
These guys are going to be the ones taking me up today.
Yes, sir. Hope you enjoy the ride.
All right, so let's go. You ready?
Let's ready. As long as you are, we're ready to go.
Sarge says bring it on. Where am I going? That side?
You're
going
to go here.
Okay. They're going to strap me in, make sure everything's tight. I'm going to set up the cameras, and we'll go from there. So who's Maverick and who's Goose?
He's Maverick.
He's Maverick.
And I'm Goose.
Talk to me, Goose.
Talk to me, Goose. That's it.
I'll be the Iceman. just feel like I got off a roller coaster.
That's it.
Oh.
Now, how does that sitting here in an hour feel?
Yeah, no, I agree.
Okay, I had the 2 hours.
Just feel like I got off a roller coaster, half an hour roller coaster. I'm exhausted, to be honest with you.
All right, so we're outside the helicopter, the chopper, the bird. What do you guys call it?
I like to treat her as a she.
A she.
She has to be taken care of, but she is a helicopter.
She's a helicopter.
That's it.
Plain and simple.
That's it.
Is there any specific model that this helicopter is?
This is, when we first bought it, it was named as the American Eurocopter EC-120B, and it's now rebranded to an Airbus Helicopters H-120.
So tell me about what you guys got going on here, because it's a souped up version of the helicopter with a little bit of toys on it, gadgets.
It is a souped up version. It's this model, specifically it's really branded for a surveillance platform, something which serves our purpose in the city, you know, phenomenally.
Mm-hmm.
And what it is, it's outfitted with certain gadgets to do that that effectively. You know, one thing we have here, this is actual an antenna down here, which we can downlink live footage to if there's a critical incident, where our command staff, the people in the key positions that need to make decisions, can make that decision effectively.
We're gonna talk about the outside and the equipment that they have on the outside and down mounted below.
That is called SARC.
This is a FLIR 8500 forward-looking infrared camera system that has three onboard cameras. It has a color camera, a forward-looking infrared camera, and a low-light television camera. It has an extreme zoom capability in both day and night versions, and we can get a very good picture from 500 feet.
But also the forward-looking infrared, that is a thermal imaging sensor, which is, as everybody is known as, is the thermal, you know, the heat signatures, of where you can see a nice cool surface and then a heat signature, a human, an animal, a vehicle running.
Very cool. So that reads the heat signature from whatever you're looking at. So if someone's hiding somewhere, you'll be able to locate them through that heat signature.
Through their heat signature, which we all admit, and there is no way to stop them.
So right now, it's daytime. So you said you guys have like a light, powerful light system for night?
Correct. Yes, we do. We do have a searchlight, which is, Sarge, what's the technical name?
It is a Spectralab Night Sun SX16 light.
And for all you flashlight buffs, that is 500 million lumens.
Lumens.
So when you think your 200 lumen flashlight's powerful enough, it kind of got you there.
What's up? It's daytime, so.
Daytime.
Rain check, we'll do a night.
Absolutely.
You guys fly at night, right?
Absolutely, we sure do. After seeing some of those nighttime patrol vlogs, we are definitely extending an invitation.
Yes. So Sarge, tell me, you seem experienced in what you're doing here.
Yes.
So in pilot terms, how long have you been flying, I guess?
I've been flying for 20 years.
Okay.
I've got approximately about 2,500 hours in helicopter at this time. Most, if not all, on this particular helicopter model, EC-120B. And I also have about 5,000 hours of 6,000 hour fixed wing airplane time as well.
So we add that together.
9,000 inch range, almost 10.
Wow. That's a lot.
That's a lot.
Lot. Yeah, that's a lot of time. What about you?
Me, I am starting at 10 Miami now, and I have 4.2 hours.
That's more hours. It's 4.2 hours more than me.
4.2, and that is eventually where I want to end up.
Yes.
Where I want to end up.
Sounds good. All right.
Is that a hammy?
Talk to me.
So right here, what you're looking at is, aft of this firewall is your turbine turbo shaft engine, and forward of the firewall is your gearbox, your actual transmission. Sarge, how many horsepower?
That is a Toromeca Arius 2F turbo shaft engine with a maximum continuous power rating of 504 horses.
504 and horsepower.
For all my Hemi lovers, okay, to put that in perspective to you, that is 500 horsepower from here to here. 500 horsepower made that big. You tell me how big your Hemi big block has to make and how big it is to make 500 horsepower. And so that's the engine, induction gearbox. Shaft right there moves at 6,000 RPM. When it goes into the gearbox, it reduces it all the way to 412 RPM. So that's a very substantial reduction. And then also has a shaft going outward to spin our tail rotor at 4,500 plus or minus RPM.
What about, like, do you guys fly over any events, like Ultra? We saw you guys at an Ultra.
Right, correct. What would happen in those events, you know, particularly Marlins Stadium and other venues in, within the city, when you have baseball games, playoffs, Miami Arena, Heat playoffs, things of that nature, we're also flying over the city at that time, protecting those events.
Perfect. And you guys are looking out for the bad guy. The eye in the sky.
Eye in the sky, baby.
Actually, the two eyes in it, well, the four eyes in the sky.
Five eyes in the sky.
Five eyes in the sky.
Well, that's two eyes, three eyes.
Yeah.
All right, so up in the air, are there any hazards?
Lots of hazards. Buildings can be a hazard, like the Four Seasons. Gotta make sure we don't hit that.
Tall buildings? Okay,
tall buildings. Drones, a huge hazard.
You guys hear that? He said drones. Remember the vlog? Told you.
It's bad. Birds. Birds have actually knocked down helicopters. Those can be a problem. Cranes can be a huge hazard, especially if we don't know about them.
Okay, so what about the parasailer that we saw out there on the tour?
Now the parasailer, just to say something about that, they are not a hazard. They are operating very legally. They're overflying an area we typically don't fly over, which is open water.
Okay,
they're just very pretty looking.
You guys are the police. We're the police.
The police.
Are we the police of the air as well? For instance, if there's a news helicopter up or a tourist helicopter and they're over one of our scenes, we take precedence. Do we have the authority to say, hey, we need you guys to scoot over and move, and so we can take over here?
When it comes to that, we have a great working relationship with our fellow aviators up in the sky, whether it be a news chopper, another surveillance platform, where we are all in contact with the Miami International Airport's air traffic control, and we will request that we have them, due to what we're working, to please give us space. And as always, we all tend to work together and they comply.
This hangar that you're at here, which hangar is this?
This is the United States Coast Guard Air Station Miami. Once again, air station. This is where all the operations for this region of the United States Coast Guard takes place. They house fixed wing and rotary wing aircraft here.
All right, guys, so you got to see what it's like to be in the air unit and some of their daily functions. You got some nice aerial shots of the city of Miami, and they promised us that we're gonna go up with them at night. So we're gonna do another vlog where maybe we'll do some patrolling at nighttime so you guys can check that out. So all in all, it's a pretty interesting day.
All right, guys, they briefed me how to take off. It's a great vlog, possibly our last one. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, follow us on YouTube, and we'll see you next vlog, hopefully. All right, guys!
Miggy, I love you, man, but what are you doing?
Taking off.
It's a dream world. It's a dream world. Good luck, buddy.
It's movie magic, man. What are you doing?
See you tonight.
Adios, guys.